Object-oriented programming has been ruling the world of enterprise-grade software development for decades, for many good reasons. But there are also reasons for the opposite, for its downfall. How come? In this demonstration, I will show you the secret ingredient of object-oriented design, from which it draws the enormous power in modeling complex business domains. And then? Then we shall make one step further down that road and you will see. What looks like the greatest power of object-oriented programming will also be its peril. I believe you, the programmer, should understand both sides of it for your own good. This is the portion of code I want to draw your attention to. It is a page model in the ASP.NET Core Razor Pages application. And here is one of the wonders of object-oriented programming, dependency injection. We can modify behavior via a private member, which is injected through the constructor. That's very nice. Though it is not what I wanted to show you in this demonstration. It's really powerful. It's really interesting. The most interesting thing about this dependency is that it is not a real object. It is a factory of real objects. So that is another great invention in object-oriented design. The real dependency, the real object that will do the job for us, it is only created when needed. Again, that is not what I wanted to show you in this demonstration, but I'm so delighted with things like this that I couldn't skip them. The subject of this demonstration is the object, the product of that factory itself. What is it? This is the interface. The factory is returning an interface, but there will always be concrete implementations, the objects implementing that interface, and the factory will effectively return one of those objects. Here, this is the interface, and that is what I wanted to talk to you about in this demonstration, because polymorphism based on interfaces is what I will identify as the greatest power of object-oriented programming. Interface-based polymorphism is the polymorphism not burdened by inheritance. Inheritance is a double-edged sword in any object-oriented programming language. It may bring benefits to your design, but it also restricts the design. Sometimes not in the way you will like. But interfaces don't have those limitations. Here's what this interface is doing. It is receiving the price of an item we are selling and the context within which that sale is being executed, for example, the content of the shopping cart or whatever. And it returns a sequence of discount application objects. Polymorphically, we don't know how it will generate that sequence. Each concrete implementation of this interface will do it differently, and it will be through the selection of the right object that we will attain the desired functionality at the consuming end. As I already pointed out, I consider that the greatest power of object-oriented programming. There's the whole bunch of implementations over here. Look here. This one is detecting a substring in the title of a book and decides whether to apply the discount to that book or not. It does benefit from inheritance in particular. That is another power of object-oriented programming. And I think it is doing that in the way where inheritance doesn't show its dark side. It doesn't pose much limitations to this implementation. If you looked into the implementation of the base class, you would see that there is only one level of inheritance, and I find a single level inheritance a powerful tool in object-oriented design. Also, if you wish to inspect the source code from this demo, I will kindly invite you to join the growing community on my Patreon page. Become the sponsor, join the others. See you there. Now back to interface-based polymorphism. What if we needed a brand new kind of that iDiscount interface implementation? For example, applying multiple discounts in parallel, applying each of them to the same input price. How would we do that in this object model? Just create a new class and nothing more than that. This new discount would wrap other discounts as requested. It would be another iDiscount implementation, so the interface-based polymorphism comes into this picture again. And why do I consider this so powerful tool in design? Because while designing this brand new class, this complicated class, I think it is more complex than most of other implementations in this domain model. I'm not even touching any other. There could be 100 other implementations, each minding its own business. This new implementation doesn't affect any of them at design time. Every implementation in this project tree is having its own unique responsibility, and so does this one. This one is applying many discounts and joining their results. I will quickly implement it through a link expression. That is the easiest way to implement this. Even this line uncovers another strength of object-oriented programming: delegation. So if you do have many classes that are just implementing interfaces, then you will be able to delegate to concrete implementations of those interfaces and leave them be. Just collect the results of applying whatever method you wanted, you needed, and collect the results and work with the results further down. It is the interface-based polymorphism that I favor over any other feature in object-oriented design. Look here. This class is implementing the iDiscount interface, which is specific to this business domain. I have implemented the entire feature in the business model without touching a single other class in the model. If I wanted to test, it would be testing this class and nothing else. If I wanted to deploy, I would only fear bugs in this place, nothing else. And even this implementation is building on top of interface-based polymorphism elsewhere, because this get discount amounts call inside the select menu operator, it's also returning the interface, the iEnumerable, and it is subject to an extension method, select menu, which is consuming the iEnumerable and returning another iEnumerable. It's interfaces all the way through. I haven't even seen a concrete class in this entire implementation, and it will work perfectly when fitted together at runtime in form of an object, an instance of this class, when fitted together with other objects, the instances of other classes in this model. Think about that. Don't forget to visit me on Patreon and to become the sponsor of this channel. See you in the next episode.